Welcome to the Grade 4 presentation of the Festival of Light and Peace, where we will honor and celebrate various holidays around the world.
Tonight we begin our celebration with Chinese New Year. Please welcome Mrs. Lante's class as they tell us the story of this festive holiday. La la, grandmother, grandmother, tell me again the legend why we celebrate Chinese New Year.
Dear, I never tire of that story. Once upon a time, long, long ago, there was a man-eating monster called Yang. He lived deep in the ocean. He would sleep every day of the year, except on the last day of the lunar year, which is when the cold winter months would turn into spring. On this night, Yang would come on land to attack and eat whatever he could find. This was the night that everyone lived in terror.
That sounds so scary. What if he ate me?
Yes, this was a fear many had. As the story goes,
year after year, Yang returned. As this was a beast that was far too powerful for anyone to defeat. Many had tried, but all had perished. Every New Year's Eve, all the villagers would take their loved ones, old and young, deep into the mountainside to take shelter from the beast.
Quickly, we must head to the mountains to hide, otherwise we will be eaten by the Nian.
Quickly, everyone, nightfall will be here soon. We must head to safety now.
One year on that night, a traveler came to town searching for food and shelter.
I am hungry and need a place to stay. Can anyone help me?
Everyone, with the exception of an old lady, was far too busy packing to pay him any kindness, or offer him a simple plate of dumplings, or a place to sleep.
I will help you. Sit, eat. My journey can wait.
Now we must go. Yan is coming. He will soon be here. We must go to the mountains for safety.
After his meal, the passerby was touched by the lady's generosity and decided to bestow a long-hidden secret of how to get rid of the Chinese New Year's beast.
Go. I will stay here and fight Yan and pay for it.
The old man sent the old woman to go hide in the mountains while he stayed behind. That evening, when Yen arrived at the village, all the houses were dark, except the one in which the old woman lived. As Yen saw the light, he licked his lips with anticipation and approached the house. He sensed a feast awaited.
Food!
Suddenly, Yen was greeted with deafening noises of firecrackers sounding endlessly. The monster was frightened and startled.
Next, he saw that the house was covered in red paper. That scared me and even more, and it took off, running back into the ocean.
When the villagers returned, they were surprised to see that the old man wasn't harmed. Everyone was eager to learn what he did to survive in the end. The old man told the villagers that Nian was afraid of loud noises and the color red.
The next year, the villagers stayed up all night, lit firecrackers, lit red lanterns all around their houses, posted red paper on their walls and doors, wore red clothing, danced a lot of music, and banged on loud gongs and drums.
That year, and every year since, Nian has never returned. That eventually became a tradition and how to celebrate Chinese New Year.
Thank you, Ms. Lante's class, for that wonderful story. Next, we present the story of Las Posadas, which is celebrated by many Spanish-speaking families.
Thank you.
Las posadas means inn or place to stay. Se celebra las posadas para la Navidad en México.
Las Posadas tells the story of Mary and Joseph searching for an inn so that Mary can rest from her long journey.
She's going to have a baby, and that baby is going to be called Jesus. Es un cuento de María y José.
Ellos buscan una posada porque María está muy cansada y pronto nace el niño Jesús.
89% of the people in Mexico are Roman Catholic.
Es una celebración muy importante.
Las posadas last for 9 days.
People wear their traditional clothing and carry candles in a procession through their towns and cities.
Las posadas duran nueve días.
Some children dress as Mary and Joseph or carry figurines of them, going from door to door, reenacting the journey to Bethlehem.
Ellos van frente a frente en su pueblo. At each door, the travelers sing a traditional poem asking for shelter at the inn. En cada puerta, los peregrinos cantan un poema tradicional pidiendo posada.
The innkeeper recites the poem back, telling them there is no room in his inn. He says they must continue on their journey.
Aquí no hay posada.
En el nombre del cielo, os pido posada, pues no puede andar mi esposa amada. Aquí no es mesón. Sigan adelante, yo no debo haber, no sé afortunante.
Mary and Joseph go from house to house, asking for a place to stay, but no one will let them in.
José y yo vamos de casa a casa pidiendo hospedaje para pasar la noche, porque yo estoy exhausta, pero nadie nos abre la puerta. Finally, Joseph tells the last innkeeper that Mary is going to have a baby. They open the door and invite them in.
Por fin alguien nos acoge.
Mi esposa es María, es reina del cielo. Madre va a ser del divino bebé.
¿Eres tú, José? Tu esposa es María, entre peregrinos. No los conocía. Respect the five pillars as basic acts that they must follow. One pillar is called Sewickley. and it means there is fast each year during the month called Ramadan.
Ramadan begins on the ninth month of the Islamic calendar, the night they look to the sky and see the first sign of the new moon appear.
During Ramadan, people only eat and drink when it's dark outside. This is to remind Muslims of the blessing of food.
Each night, families gather at sunset to eat a meal called iftar. After the meal, they practice prayers and read parts of the Quran.
The Quran? Muslims believe the Quran is a holy book that is Allah's word. By the end of Ramadan, they have read the entire Quran.
On the day after the month of Ramadan, Muslims celebrate their month-long fast with a holiday called Eid.
Eid is a time for Muslims to give food and money to the poor. They clean their homes and decorate them with lights.
Muslims also prepare special sweets and other dishes for family and friends.
Eid is also a time for Muslims of the entire community to gather for prayers and to congratulate each other on completing the Ramadan fast.
Here's a poem titled Eid Night, adapted by Barbara Moore.
Sorrow light, new moon bright, high up in the sky tonight. Shining bright, shining clear, telling us that Eid is here.
Eid Mubarak, happy Eid we say. Tomorrow we will have a feast and such a happy day.
At home we'll have a party with bright new clothes to wear and games to play with all our friends and lovely food to share.
We always must remember to thank Allah as we pray for family, food, and clothes He gives us every day.
Thank you for that wonderful poem and insight into those Muslim holidays.
Next up is Miss Latte's class as they present their ballet from another favorite from the Nutcracker.
Blessings of wealth and good fortune.
Diwali is the most enthusiastically enjoyed festival in India. People of different nationalities, races, religions, and backgrounds come together to share their joys, generating a feeling of universal brotherhood and interreligious harmony.
Various Indian dances are presented during Diwali. One of the most popular styles is Bhangra. Please join us in our celebration of Diwali as we present a dance in this fun and festive style.
How they choose to spend their money. The The second red candle represents Ujamaa.
The fifth principle of Kwanzaa is Naya.
Naya!
Naya means purpose.
This principle reminds people to reflect on their purpose in the world, both as individuals and as a community. The second green candle represents Naya.
The sixth principle of Kwanzaa is Kuumba.
Kuumba!
Kuumba means creativity.
On this day, people are encouraged to appreciate traditional art forms like dancing, music, weaving, and painting. Art can both be a celebration of heritage and a form of self-expression. The third red candle represents Kuumba.
The seventh principle of Kwanzaa is Imani.
Imani!
Imani means faith.
Faith can be in our sides, ourself, in our power, and in our community. Imani represents the lightning in the last candle.
Near the end of Kwanzaa, families have a big feast called Kurmu. Like at most big feasts, there can be music, dancing, storytelling, and speech. And of course, there's lots of good food. Kwanzaa is the time to remember the proud heritage and traditions of African Americans and to dream about the future. It is a celebration of family and community. After the feast, people shout Harambee.
Harambee!
Let's all pull together to make our world even better.
Next, we have Miss Whelan's class as they present our final holiday ballet to another familiar tune. Take it away, Mr. Buckley.
Christmas.
Christmas is celebrated each year on December 25th. This is the date chosen to commemorate the birth of Jesus Christ.
The story told is that he was born in a manger because there was no room for his mother and father at the inn.
Many believe that the pastor, Martin Luther, first added lighted candles to a tree. Walking to his home one winter evening, he was awed by the brilliance of the stars twinkling among the evergreens.
To capture the scene for his family, he erected a tree inside his home and wired its branches with lighted candles.
Christians celebrate Christmas by singing songs, visiting with family, enjoying festive meals, and giving gifts to loved ones.
They decorate their homes with candles and holiday decorations, and many display a tree with lights and ornaments.
In the spirit of Christmas, please help us conclude this evening's performance by joining in as we sing Jingle Bells. Mr. Buckley, take it away.